The National Health Service.
In the past, we've had all sorts of public health services, such as main drainage and water supply. Everyone makes use of these services, and everyone pays for them. Refuse disposal is another of these services. And so is street cleaning. These are all public health services, but the new Health Act proposes to organize personal health services in the same way. This new health service will be organized on a national scale as a public responsibility. The cost of the service will be met from rates, taxes, and national insurance, and so everyone will pay for it. And everyone will benefit from it. When you're ill, you won't have to pay for treatment. Yours, whenever you want it, with your own choice of doctor. And that goes for the whole family. The scheme is comprehensive. It's not only to help you when you're ill, but to help to keep you well. And of course, the younger generation will stand to gain the biggest benefits of all.
Leaflet is coming through your letterbox one day soon. Or maybe you've already had your copy. Read it carefully. It tells you what the new National Health Service is and how you can use what it offers. Hospitals and specialist services, medicines, drugs and appliances, care of the teeth, care of the eyes, maternity services, home health services. The new scheme starts on July the 5th. But there's one thing you should do at once. Choose your doctor now. That's most important. Study the leaflet, then keep it by you. You'll need it for reference.
What's it like for the doctors here in Britain who have to live under this kind of state control?
And you're a family doctor?
Yeah, I suppose we'd call them GPs or general practitioners here.
Uh-huh, right, so you have like a family practice of...
Yeah, it's an NHS practice. We have 9 doctors within that practice.
And you're paid for by the government?
Yeah. Paid for by the government,
so you work for the government?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You're a government-paid doctor?
Absolutely.
A patient comes to see you. Before you treat them, do you have to call the government insurance company before you can treat them?
Right. No, I don't deal with money at all on an everyday basis.
Have you ever had to say no to someone who was sick and needed help?
No, never.
Have you heard of anyone being in the hospital and being removed because they couldn't pay their bill?
No, never, and I wouldn't want to work in that system.
So working for the government, you probably have to use public transportation?
No, so I have a car that I use, and you know, I drive.
An old beater? You live in the kind of rough part of town, or...?
I live in a terrific part of town. It's called Greenwich. It's a lovely house. It's a three-story house.
How many other families have to live in that house with you?
No, so we would live, that's 4 bedrooms, but my wife and my son, you know, it's just the 3 of us there.
How much do you pay for that?
£550,000. Yeah,
so
pounds.
Yeah. So $1 million.
Yeah.
You're a government-paid doctor.
Yes.
On a national health insurance,
yes,
healthcare plan here.
Yes.
And you live in a $1 million home.
Yes. I think probably my friends think we do quite well.
Really? How well do you do?
I earn around 85,000, including pension.
£85,000?
£85,000 a year. And that includes pension that they would pay into me. They probably earn just over £100,000 within my practice.
£100,000, so that's almost $200,000.
Yes, absolutely. The money that we earn, we get paid by what we do. So the better we do for our patients, then the more that we get paid.
What do you mean?
There's a new system, and in that new system, if the most number of your patients have low blood pressures, or you get most of your patients to stop smoking, or you get most of your patients to have things like mental health reviews if they're unwell, or low cholesterols, then you get paid more.
In other words, this year, if you get more people that are your patients to stop smoking,
yes,
you'll get more money.
Yes, absolutely.
This year, you'll earn more.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So doctors do not, in America, do not necessarily have to fear having a universal health care.
No, I think if you want to have $2 or $3 million homes and 4 or 5 nice cars and 6 or 7 nice televisions, then maybe, yeah, you need to practice somewhere where you can earn that. But I think we live comfortably here. And London's an expensive city, but I think we live very comfortably.
And you're getting by okay on the $1 million home, the Audi,
yeah,
and the flat-screen TV.
Yeah, we're coping with those.
I, along with, I think, something like 5 million other people, yes, do ensure to enable me to go into hospital on the day I want, at the time I want, and with the doctor I want. And for me, that is absolutely vital.
Yo.
Yo.
Can you help me with my gov project?
What do you mean?
Can you tell me what you think about NHS?
Yeah.
No, the National Health Service.
What I think about it?
Yeah.
I think it's, I don't really know a lot about it, but isn't it like free healthcare for anyone?
Yeah, what do you think about that?
I think it's spending too much money.
Alright.
I don't really know anything about it, though.
Alright, I'm making a video about it.